Thank you, Mr. Speaker, for the opportunity to debate this adjournment motion. I would love for us to not even have to debate adjournment motions, and that would be possible if we had a permanent calendar. And that is something that would be really beneficial for all members, but more importantly, for the work in our constituencies, because it makes it difficult to plan in advance when you don't have a permanent calendar, to schedule things when you don't really know exactly what's coming and things are shifting around and you can't plan very far in advance. And so that is actually, it's to the detriment of the work that MLAs do for their constituents. And so that is one reason that a permanent calendar would be important. This is an issue that keeps coming up again and again. And it has even been a recommendation. There was the report on how to make this legislature more family-friendly, and there's a whole list of things we could do. This is one of them, Mr. Speaker. It's not a radical new idea. This is something that is done in other legislatures, legislature in Prince Edward Island, for example, but also in Parliament in Ottawa. They know when they're going to be in their ridings. They know when they're going to be in Ottawa, for example. And so it's just nonsense that we don't have this. And when people hear about this, they just can't believe it. And it's not the same as, oh, well, you know, I have shift work, and so someone having shift work, and they only get their schedule. A lot of people here travel. I know that I spend about 5 hours a week driving. There are people in this house who travel even further. And to figure out childcare arrangements for certain members in this house, to be able to plan, and as I said, let alone the personal part, the family-friendly part, to be able to plan their work in their constituencies, Mr. Speaker. And so this is something that would benefit everyone, including members on the government side. And so it's hard to understand why we can't just have a permanent calendar. This is something that could be done. PP Locke could take it up. We could actually just stop having to debate these adjournment motions, Mr. Speaker. And so I call once again on the government to just do this. We can work through it together. All parties can help to figure out a reasonable calendar, make sure there's enough sitting days. That's one important thing. And I'd say we could even make sure that there are sitting days where we have routine business, and then we could do committee in the afternoon, because we don't want to be missing out on these opportunities for routine business when there's committee. But that's been the trend, where we don't go to committee of the whole, but rather just to economic policy to deal with the legislation. All that to say, Mr. Speaker, I don't have a problem necessarily with adjournment motions, this adjournment motion. I have a problem with the fact that we keep on having to adjourn because we don't have a calendar. It's 2022. Can we please just get this thing sorted and stop wasting time in the legislature? Thank you, Mr. Speaker.